This is Hamid Reza Gohari Darabkhani. I'm professor of low carbon and renewable energy systems. I'm part of the Center for Renewable Energy and Sustainable Engineering. And today I'm here to present you with the Renewable Energy Lab and the facilities, state-of-the-art facilities we have here in our school. As you know, renewable energy systems and low carbon systems are quite critical, quite important for achieving net zero targets by 2050. For instance, over 85% of the buildings has to be zero carbon ready by 2050 to be able to achieve net zero. And we are practicing all major renewable energy technology experiments here for undergraduate, postgraduate, and PhD students, and for the research projects. It starts actually with wind energy, small-scale wind facility, which undergraduate students mainly operating wind, and they work on the distance and the angle of the blades and measure the power generated. We also have solar systems, which they are connected to hydrogen generator, which basically through electrolysis, hydrogen is going to be generated. And we have small scale fuel cells that they can generate power, and we can see a green hydrogen generation and regeneration of power through hydrogen, which is state of the art technology as we speak. We have different setups. So the solar panels, which are going to absorb electricity and push electricity to the electrolysis and generating power through fuel cell. So this is new energy lab facility. This is really critical to bring all renewable systems synchronizing and working together in a smart building. So the system brings 400 watts of wind turbine energy from top of the roof. We do have trackable and fixed solar panels on top of the roof, so we can see how solar energy can be generated when the angle of solar panel is fixed or is tracking direction of sunlight. We do have access to grid, and the system is talking to grid, so we can basically bring wind energy or solar energy and store the energy in the batteries here, or we can use electricity to generate hydrogen and store hydrogen in bottles and use the hydrogen to regenerate power in a fuel cell system. So my colleague Majid shows how wind turbine is going to be connected to the wind commander, and from there it goes to the wind battery, and then from the battery we can direct electricity to the electronic load, as you can see here. So now wind turbine is in operation, and the electricity generated by wind can go to the electronic load and to be used. We can also use solar energy same way, but I want to show you how basically electricity can generate hydrogen through electrolysis processes. So Majid, can you just connect electricity to hydrogen generator? So electricity is connected to hydrogen generator. It goes to the storage. So if you click power, it starts generating hydrogen, and the hydrogen is going to be stored in the three bottles, which are located on top of this column of the unit. There is a dedicated lab view system. We can see all the operations. We can handle this, the operation manually or using basically the lab view program. For all smart buildings, zero carbon ready buildings, we need to have a combination of different technologies, from solar, silicon or organic PV, wind turbines, it might be small scale horizontal wind turbine or vertical wind turbines, and In addition to basically heat pumps, energy storage using batteries or fuel cell, or including low carbon systems like micro turbines, which we have a dedicated lab for micro gas turbine systems generating combined heat and power at the same time. This is our dedicated wind turbine lab, which we basically use to generate wind at different speeds and measure the power generated through the wind turbine through the analog and digital system we have here. Basically, if I start generation of wind through this wind tunnel, I can change the speed of wind, and based on the specific speed of wind, we can see how much power is generated. Of course, I can adjust the wind speed and see how the power is going to change. The turbine RPM is going to be measured here. We have wind speed dedicated here. The power generated has got three phases, and we are measuring all three phases of the generated power. There is a lab view dedicated software which we can measure actually the electricity generated, the amplitude of the electricity, as well as the power generated. All the generated RPM, the rotor RPM, and wind speed, which is 3.5 meter per second at the moment, can be seen here. Of course, we have limits of wind speed. The maximum normally it goes to close to 10 meters per second. In real wind turbines, we go maximum up to 20 meters per second. And after that, the wind turbine is going to be shut and it's not going to operate anymore due to safety reasons. The maximum efficiency in wind turbines are close to 59%. There is a Betz's limit, and wind energy is one of the best actually energies, renewable energies, which has got the maximum conversion rates and the highest possible efficiency. We are on the roof of the science building where our renewable energy lab is located actually in this building. We do have fixed angle solar panels, silicon solar panels, 400 watts, 100 watt each. And we do have a trackable solar panel, as you can see here with motors. It can track the direction of sun and absorbs the maximum level of sunshine and generate electricity accordingly. We do also have a dedicated wind turbine, which is linked with a new energy lab. The wind turbine is a small scale horizontal wind turbine generating 400 watts of electricity. Based on the level of wind speed, it can generate a certain amount of electricity, which can be measured with any lab system. So this is British Electricity Life. As you can see in this website, easily you can add the time, at the real time, to see how level of electricity is generated from which sources of electricity generation. For time being, about 48% of electricity still comes from gas, power stations burning natural gas. But we have about 21% electricity, about 9.2 gigawatts coming from wind, about 1.4 gigawatts, which is a share of 3.3% from solar, and some other means of renewables, including biomass in Drax power station, which is 7.2% of the electricity. We are dedicated to achieve Paris Agreement targets. And in this renewable energy lab, we do our best to teach our students and perform our research work in direction of achieving net zero by 2050. The targets dedicated for carbon emission by 2030 in this website is 100 grams of carbon dioxide per kilowatt by 2030 and achieving net zero by 2050. That's a very ambitious target, but we work hard towards this target. As we speak, it's about 300 grams of carbon dioxide per kilowatt. So a lot of research fundings, a lot of research works, a lot of dedicated engineers and researchers have to work hand to hand together to be able to bring different sources of renewable and low carbon energy system together. And this renewable energy lab is aiming to help achieving that target. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video and seeing our facilities. Please do get in touch if you have any question. Just approach our website, our dedicated pages of colleagues, as well as the Center for Renewable and Sustainable Engineering. Thank you very much, and thanks for watching us.